What's up, everybody? Tim from LiveCaseBreak.com here. We have a split American League, National League on the middle box of Immaculate Baseball here between Joe, who has the NL, and Tim, who has the AL. Any of the old franchises will go to their current counterparts. And if there's any team that doesn't have one, it'll just be random between the two of you. So I only have two boxes left, guys. Single boxes are $220 or $112.50 a piece to split. Here's the box. We got our first base card parallel. I was wondering when we were going to get one of those. There's an empty little mini. Okay, this is actually probably going to sell really, really well. Hisashi Iwakuma Gold Rainbow. 4 out of 5. American League for Tim. He sells incredibly well. A lot better than anybody thinks. So 4 out of 5, I'm guessing that's like a gold rainbow parallel. That's what it looks like. 4 out of 5. Then we have number 20 out of 99, David Holmberg, National League. Cincinnati Reds. Jumbo Game Used Jersey. We have Donnie Mattingly, New York Yankees, 1 out of 49, American League. 1 out of 49, American League, and oh boy, sick Legends hit. Game Used Bat, Ty Cobb, 20 out of 99. 20 out of 99, hold on a second. Chat is not updating. Joe, Tim said good luck. And to make it nasty. So 20 out of 99, Ty Cobb. So American League, game used bat. Next up, we have the Crime Dog. 26 out of 49. Tampa Bay, another American League hit. 4 to 1, American League over National League so far. Tampa Bay, next hit. Ellis Burks for Boston, 31 out of 99. On-card clubhouse signatures. 5 to 1. 5 to 1 AL over NL. I'm waiting for Joe's taking a beating comment. They always make me laugh, I don't know why. So Ellis Burks, 31 out of 99. And Adrian Beltre for the American League. 44 out of 99. The American League just thwomped that break. Texas Rangers, 44 out of 49. Well, nothing to dispute there. All American League. 6 cards to 1. Poor Joe took a beating. There you go, Joe. I said it for you. A beating like no other. That's what your post usually says. That Kuma's nice. That'll sell pretty well. 4 out of 5. Ty Cobb game used bat and the Donnie baseball too. Hope he gets hot, man. 20 out of 99. I have NT hockey in stock too, if anyone wants to take a stab at that. Whew. Alright, let me... Tim, you just clean house, brother. Poor Joe. I will not cut a card in half. Cut the Holmberg in half. Look at that. The man doesn't even care about a $7 return. I don't know anything about David Holmberg, unfortunately. Oh, I wouldn't go that bad, Nate. Perfect game. Good night, Jeff. Have a good one, man. Alright, everybody, I got 2 boxes left of Immaculate. They are $220 a piece or $112.50 for a split AL and NL. You guys want them? Great. If not, I think we'll call it an evening. I've got NT hockey in stock as well. And plenty of other stuff in stock too. There's some new bench warmers. Tribute WBC, they got a box of Ginter left.
Lots of Trinity and Sterling, all sorts of fun stuff.
Sorry, Joe. If you guys, yeah, you guys can obviously do a randomizer for the ALNL. Just both of you guys said you wanted your division, so it worked that time, or league. I did tell Joe sorry for you, bud. Jay Coop, yep. Single box, 220. You need a link? You need a link, or you want to send direct PayPal? All right, hold on a second. Let me get you a link, buddy. All right, so I only have one box of Immaculate left, guys. There you go, Jay Coop. If you do it that way, you get you earn some rewards points, bud. Hold on a second, Tim. Let me see. Okay, there you go. Jay Coop looks like he's all set. Yeah, the NT hockey I have is a fresh 8-box case that has not been opened at all. Guys, first person to claim the last box of Immaculate gets it too. Or it'll just hang out here and probably be a single box night sometime soon. I just don't want to have a couple guys all saying they want it. Dave B just answered you. Yourself up with some Ginter. You feel dirty. I just want to see.
don't even watch Triple Threats.
Usually if you don't watch, that's when something nice comes out too. Second, Dave.
It's a new day, but it all feels so. It's a good life, that's what I'm told. But everything at all just feels the same.
No, I was quoting a price for someone, Nate. Alright, I think Jason is all set for Box of Immaculate. Jason, alright, you're good to go, buddy. Wants the right. Good luck, man. Am I still recording? I am still recording. Perfect. Okay. Dave, I can give you a link if that's easier, buddy. I've got one made up. Give me an hour with Dave, though. All right, Jason C. Average size box here, just six cards, so nothing extra.
I love challenges.
Okay, Gene Segura out of 99 for the Brew Crew. This is your base card. I know somebody who wants this. We have a Brewer Super Collector. Especially Segura and Ryan Braun, so if you're interested in letting this go, I know somebody who wants. Super short break. Out of 99. No free break tonight, no. Alright, Brandon Phillips. 66 out of 99. Immaculate Swatches. Next up is 81 out of 99. Oh, that's Buxton. Nice. Thought it was a scrubby twin. No, Byron Buxton game used.
Not too shabby.
81 out of 99. You got a nasty looking patch coming up next. Pull out the question mark for it. Here you go. Out of 25, Alfonso Soriano, Cubbies, game used patch. That's pretty cool. I have no idea if Bryant's in this. Trying to get this to focus. There you go, Jason. Triple color action on the Alfonso Soriano. 24 out of 25. Two cards left. You have a Shelby Miller gold ink for the Cardinals on black tweed. It's kind of like a glove fabric they have him sign up. Beautiful. 4 out of 10. Very nice. I think Nate's mad at me. He's not answering me on Ustream. So 4 out of 10, Shelby Miller gold. There he is. Did you see the Gene Segura? Yeah, these do look nice. 4 out of 10. And your last card. Here you go, Jason. Pretty nice auto here. Cutting that Braun. That Braun's probably a $9-$10 card, I bet. As long as you get it up within a week. 9 out of 15, and you got silver ink. Dale Murphy for the Bravos, immaculate ink. Not too bad of a box, Jason. Not too bad. And Dave B, I believe, has taken that last box, so I think we're all sold out. I think Joe's quoting Metallica, I'm not sure. Yeah, Nate Woodard in the room would love the Segura right here. If you PM Nate Woodard in the room, he'll definitely make you an offer on the Gene Segura. He PCs Brewers base cards, so that's his big PC. Jason, we're just kidding with Nate. The last couple of breaks, he's hit nothing but Brewers base. It's crazy. It's having some bad luck. Alright, so there's your box, man. Not too bad. Shelby Miller, probably the best card, I would say. Soriano. Buxton, at least. And a nice Dale Murphy out of 15. It's all you, and Dave's taking the last one. So we've successfully sold out of all of our immaculate. And Dave, whenever you're ready, buddy, just let me know. You said your PayPal's taking forever. Hey, that one came right through, Dave. That was a pretty solid box. I don't think it was the best box. $70? Oh, come on, Nate. Now you're just being negative. I never thought I'd hear that from you. Reed, what's up, man? Whoever got the Mark Grace auto. I don't remember who got the Mark Grace auto, honestly. So, I'm not sure. Here we go! Dave with the last box! Let's see if this has some mojo in it. Yeah, Dave grabbed the last box, yep. One glove relic. We have not hit any sell sheet card the entire night. Not even like close to sell sheet. Let's see if it's a fat box together. Skinny box. Gonna have a redemption in it. No redemption, just 6 cards. Could be a whammy. Could be a whammy. It's a really nice RPA on the bottom. Alright, we're gonna slow roll this for the last immaculate box. We probably won't buy this stuff again unless it gets really cheap. First one, Andrew McCutchen out of 99. Nice base card. Second hit, Carl Crawford for Boston. Dear Lord, if only Larry could have pulled this card would have gotten a horrible, horrible fate. 9 out of 99. Instead, it goes into Dave B's Man Cave collection. Alright, next card. 5 out of 99, Buster Posey. Buster Posey's number 5, isn't he? San Fran, jersey number 101. I would waterboard that card. Buster Posey, 5 out of 99. Alright. Nobody's disagreeing with you, Joe. Nobody's disagreeing with you. We have the greatest, Wade Boggs. That's actually a pretty cool card. It's actually probably the nicest looking subset in the product. 15 out of 25. Posey's 18? Wow, why did I think he was 5? So 15 out of 25 makes 2 color. Definitely the greatest mustache, mate. I agree. One of the greatest. You got 2 cards left. Junior Lake, 89 out of 99. 89 out of 99. I appreciate you guys waiting to diss it until you're all sold out. Boom! You hit a monster there! You have a really nice RPA, at least. Panini needs to learn something about baseball RPAs, though, and I'll comment after I pull this. Here you go! Beautiful triple color RPA. 56 out of 99, Castellanos for Tigers. But unfortunately, all their RPAs in this are sticker autos. That makes an RPA garbage. That's a nice card, though. You guys gotta give that to it. At least give it a nice RPA comment. It's a 56 out of 99. Dave, are you double thinking, or are you thinking on the NT hockey now? I can't believe this stuff. The way they marketed this and everything, and then we get 2 cases and the breakdown like that. Yeah, off the sticker a little bit. Or 1, 2, 3 times, but yeah, I'll give it to you. Man. Not happy. Not happy. Not happy. I feel ripped off too, to be honest with you guys. They marketed it like the freaking next coming of NT. So basically, Panini has put out 1 good baseball product in the last 8 years, and it was NT Hockey. Well, actually, the last, like, 5. You're breaking. Yeah, not even close to what they advertised. Agreed. Well, does anybody want anything else? We could just sit around and bash Immaculate for a while if you guys want to. Again, Reed, I'm not sure if you heard me, but I don't know who got the Mark Grace. I don't know.